There are situations when we need a surface to emit light. Here, for example, we have a living room with a television. We already have a dedicated surface material assigned to the screen. The image with the couple dancing the tango is linked to the color channel. If we render the scene with all the interior lights turned off, the render image will look like this. Obviously, it's not what we would see in real life, because the screen emits light depending on the brightness of the picture being displayed. The correct setup of surface material in this case is having the image placed in the luminance channel. We don't need the color channel to be turned on at all. Let's render the scene. We've taken one step forward, but still there's not enough light coming from the screen. In the Illumination tab of Surface Material, increasing the value of Generate GI Strength to 1000 will further enhance the result. Let's render the scene again to see the difference. Now we have an amount of light that can be considered as realistic, but at a cost of plenty of artifacts on the wall and the ceiling. We can play with the render settings, but even the highest values wouldn't help us get rid of these artifacts. There's a much simpler way to resolve this issue without having to use high render settings, thus avoiding a sky-high render time. Let's go back to the surface settings of the screen, and under the Illumination tab, turn off the Generate GI. This way, the screen will be illuminated, but will not contribute to the lighting of the living room. In addition, we'll simulate the light coming from the screen with an area light having the following properties. Main intensity at 30%, with a slightly reddish color that matches the picture on the television. Illumination angle at 130 degrees. And most important, illuminating in one direction only. Let's place the area light in front of the television and make a render in order to see the result. It's almost perfect, but we forgot to set one value correctly. A screen of this size should emit much more light than this, and that light should reach the opposite wall. The dashed line clearly shows the light distance value is too low in our case. Let's raise this value. And render the scene again. The simulated light coming from the screen looks realistic. We can consider this problem solved. And finally, let's see how the complete living room looks with the rest of the lights and furniture. Please note, although ArchiCAD 18 with CineRender Engine makes it possible to offer a more realistic render, rendering itself takes a lot of time. When setting up your newly created light and making the test renders to see the results, it's wise to hide everything possible from your scene, especially other light sources. This way you'll save a lot of precious time.